WRAF. I'm Bryan Race. Just learned that BP apparently wants the social networking site Twitter to shut down a fake BP account that apparently has been mocking the company. Twitter's response, they want BP to shut down the oil leak that's ruining the ocean. And you can get that message clearly communicated in less than 140 characters. 90.9 and 88.5 WRAF. Hope you're finding a way to beat back the heat this afternoon. 94 here at our studios on the TFC campus. There are some new laws that are about to take effect in the state of Georgia regarding cell phones and text messaging while you're driving. I'll fill you in right after Shannon Wexelberg. The passionate sound of Shannon Wexelberg with Hail to the King. Right here on 88.5 and 90.9 WRAF. Good afternoon. I'm Bryan Race. Was mentioning just a moment ago about a new law set to take effect on July the 1st here in Georgia, where it will become illegal for anyone to read, type, or send a text message while they're driving. And the definition of driving includes being stopped at a red light or awaiting an arrow in a turn lane. And the fines are going to range just somewhere between $100 and $150. Also, teenage drivers, anybody that is under the age of 18, completely prohibited from using cell phones, regardless of whether it's a hands-free device, computers, also banned. So I guess you can't have your iPad while you're driving. That's probably a good idea. I think the whole law is a good idea. It's about 6,000 people a year are killed in distraction-related accidents. So as we say around here, we need all the listeners we can get, so make sure that you're paying attention if you're out on the roads this afternoon. Alan Archer's paying attention to the weather for us. What's the latest? We'll find out in just about 2 minutes.
Tell these stones to become bread.
Just remember, if you're driving, don't check that text. At least after July 1, you'll be in trouble. By the way, if you're following the World Cup, Switzerland beat Spain today. The reaction of the Swiss people? Neutrality, huh? Thought that was interesting. At least they're consistent. Darlene Scheck on WRAF.